welcome our neighbors. Let's say you are welcome to the presence of the Lord. Give them a warm welcome. Don't let us be stingy with our greeting. Let's welcome one another. Say, you are welcome to the presence of the Lord. You are welcome to the presence of the Lord. The Lord be with you. You are welcome. Hallelujah. You are welcome. Praise the Lord. Please rest all of us. It's a big bomber in front here. It's a big bomber in front. Next, please come here. It's a big bomber. Let's come towards the center. Emanuela, let's come to the center. It's warm. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let us.
Whatever is going to
cause you to get wisdom, get it. Because ignorance, foolishness is far more expensive. Whatever is going to cost you, whether you are a child, whether you are a mother, you are a father, you are a parent, you are a worker, whatever you are, whatever category you fall into, get wisdom. Praise the Lord. Tell your neighbor, get wisdom. There are children, tell your neighbor, say, get wisdom. Talk to your friends, say, get wisdom. Hallelujah. Can we please open our Bible to Proverbs 4? We read from 1 to 10. Proverbs 4, from 1 to 10. That's our Bible reading. Proverbs 4, from 1 to 10. He said, hear, ye children, the instruction of a father, and attend to know understanding. For I give you good doctrine. Forsake ye not my law. For I was my father's son, tender and only beloved in the sight of my mother. Verse 4. He taught me also and said unto me, let thy heart retain my words, keep my commandment and live. Get wisdom. Get understanding. Forget it not, neither decline from the word of my mouth. Forsake I not, and it shall preserve thee. Love I, and it shall keep thee. 7. Wisdom is the principal thing. Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom. And with all thy getting, get understanding. 8. Exhort her, and she will promote thee. He shall bring thee to honor when thou dost embrace her. She shall give to thy head an ornament of grace. A crown of glory shall she deliver to thee. 10. Hear, O my son, and receive my saying, and the years of thy life shall be many. Somebody shout hallelujah. The Bible starts by saying, hear, give attention. Hear, give attention. Ye children, we are all children of God. He said, would you give attention to the instruction of our Father? Give attention to the instruction of our parents. Children are growing up nowadays, and then we say, oh, our parents, they are, I don't know the language that they use. We borrow with the language where they say, it's my parents, they don't even know anything again. They say they are old school. They say they don't know anything. But the Bible is saying, hear, listen, hear what? Children. He said, children, listen. Pay attention to the instruction of your parents. Don't say they are old school. Don't say they don't know anything. Don't say they didn't go to school, they don't know much, as you know. Don't say that. Attempt to know understanding. You know, know the reason why God is saying that? You see, if you see verse 6, the Bible says, forsake her not. The Bible is using her for wisdom, don't personify wisdom. He said, forsake her not. Don't forsake wisdom. Because it do what? It will preserve you. When the parents are not there, when the elders are not there, all those words that they have given to us, it will do what? It will preserve us. You should not forsake it. Don't say what they are saying is not a lie. There's a reason why God placed parents in your life. There's a reason why God placed elders in your life. If you don't need them, you will just drop from heaven straight to the earth. But because you need elders, you need parents in your life, God allows you that you go through them so that they can guide you. So that through them you can come in contact with wisdom. Through them you can know wisdom. You don't despise them. He said, when you love wisdom, it will keep you, it will guide you. And I said, this wisdom we are talking is the principal thing, is the main thing. If you want to be successful in life, if you want to be a person to be reckoned with in life, wisdom is the principal thing. And one of the first place you can get wisdom is with your parents. One of the first place to get wisdom is where? With your parents. Don't despise it. He said, in whatever you will get wisdom, get understanding. You see, because when you get it, first he said, exalt her as you promote it. When you exalt wisdom, when you cherish wisdom, it will do what? It will promote you. Have you ever seen anyone that has wisdom and is at the bottom of the ladder? No way. There is no one that has wisdom that is at the bottom of the ladder. But go and look at it. At those children, when they are growing up, when the parents talk to them, and they say, what is he saying? What is the father saying? What is the mother saying? Go and look at them now. They are the people that are at the bottom of the ladder today. Those who say the parents don't know what they're saying, they are at the bottom of the ladder. They will not be at the bottom of the ladder in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So we must listen. There's a proverb they say in my place. They say, an older woman cannot be in the market. And you see the neck of the baby bent. And we narrate it. You see another woman in the market, and a young lady who just got married and then have a child. And then she doesn't know how to carry the baby. Then she's carrying the baby, and then the neck is bent. It's like the neck of the baby want to break. No one is telling the older woman before she will go to the younger woman and say, look, this is the best way to carry the baby. Don't break the leg of the baby. What the older woman is doing is that she's transferring wisdom to the younger one. So we should not despise people that are elderly, people that than home. Your parents, don't despise them. Say they don't know how to speak. They don't know what to say. What do they know? They don't even go to school. They can't speak good English. They may not be able to do all those things that you're saying, but they have wisdom more than you. They have what more than you? Wisdom more than you. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
What is wisdom? Somebody may ask, what is wisdom? Wisdom, according to a dictionary, is the quality of having experience. And experience, they say, it comes with age. There's no way you have everything. You can't have experience like your parents. Because it comes with age. Wisdom is the quality of having experience, knowledge, and good judgment. The quality of being wise. That's what the dictionary put it. And wisdom is something that is so precious that we should have. If they put bag full of gold, bag full of silver, and bag full of wisdom, and they give you one option to pick one. I know many people will go for gold. If gold is finished, they go for silver. They will neglect wisdom. But the Bible says wisdom is the principal thing. Solomon, when he asked opportunity to ask God for one thing, he asked God for wisdom. He asked God for what? Wisdom. And God gave him wisdom and gave him all that thing. If you have wisdom, you can buy 10 bags of gold. You can buy 10 bags of silver. So wisdom is a precious thing. And that is what the Bible says in Proverbs 3, 14 to 15. Proverbs 3, 14 to 15. It says, for the merchandise of it is better than the merchandise of silver, and the gain thereof than fine gold. She is more precious than rubies, and all the things thou canst desire are not to be compared to her. There is nothing that you desire that you can compare to wisdom. You can't compare gold to wisdom. You can't compare silver to wisdom. You can't compare it to money. Somebody may have so much money and you don't have the wisdom on how to spend it well. We've seen so many people who win lottery. They win millions of euros. They win millions of dollars. But give them some time. After 5-10 years, they come back to that same position they were in the first place. Because they don't have the wisdom on how to utilize the money that they got. So wisdom is more precious. When you possess wisdom, you are honored. You cannot be ridiculed. The people with wisdom, they are sought out. They are sought out. People look for them. People come from far and near to come and listen to the word of wisdom of Solomon. They come from far and near to listen to the word of wisdom of Solomon. So you are honored. No one can ridicule a wise man. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is what Proverbs 4:8 says. Proverbs 4:8 says, exalt her and she shall promote thee. He shall bring thee to honor when thou embrace her. And that you see with the story of Daniel and Joseph. The thing is that Daniel, a young boy, a teenager, left his country in captivity. They took him away with his other brethren, and they took them to Babylon. But he may not have everything. He may not have gold. He may not have silver. He may not have clothes. He may not have food. But he has one thing. What is it? Wisdom. He may have lost his freedom, but he has one thing. Wisdom. He said, in all thy getting, get what? Wisdom. And get understanding. Wherever you go, if you don't have anything, have wisdom and understanding. Somebody shout hallelujah. When we look at the story of Daniel, in Daniel 2, 46 to 49, I don't want us to read everything. I don't want to. Let's read 48 of it. Then the king made Daniel a great man. The king did what? The king made Daniel a great man and gave him many gifts, many great gifts, and made him ruler over the whole province of Babylon, and the chief of the governor over all the wise men of Babylon. Why did you think the king did that? Because Daniel has wisdom. Daniel was promoted because he had what? Wisdom. And he said, above all the wise men in Babylon, they made Daniel to be the head. They made Daniel to be the chief of the governor. Daniel was given gifts. Daniel was made a great man. Why? Because he has wisdom. You cannot have wisdom and still be at the lowest ladder. You will be where? At the top. Because wisdom will promote you. Wisdom will lift you up. Men will recognize you. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you see the same thing with Joseph. They strip him of everything. They strip Joseph of his clothes. They took him away from his parents. They took him away from his family. He was sold as a slave. He was in prison. But one thing they could not take from Joseph is what? Wisdom. They could not do what? They could not take the wisdom away from Joseph. Even while he was in the prison, what liberated Joseph? Wisdom. When they didn't find solution to the problem of the king, they said there's one wise man in the prison. Go and bring him. In Genesis 41, 13, 14, they go and bring him. Why are they bringing Joseph from the prison? Because he has wisdom. He has solution to the problem of people. When you have wisdom, what you have is solution to the problem of others. They will come for you. Wherever you may be, people will do what? Come for you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see some businesses, they may be in one corner of gone nowhere. But because they are the only one who can do that particular thing. There's only one. They are in the alley, the underground, people will look for them. Because you have wisdom. God will grant you wisdom. In Jesus' name. So wisdom, what it does for the people who have wisdom, that it positions you in life. It positions you. So and that is why you must have wisdom. Because nobody wants to begin to live a life of mediocre. Nobody wants to live a life of a foolish person. Nobody wants to live a life of failure. Everyone wants to live a successful life. What differentiates a fool and a wise person is the choice that we make. The choices that we make. You see some people, they make foolish choices and they know this one they are foolish. And you see some, they make wise choices and we say, oh, they are successful. It is wisdom that make you to make the right choices. If you are not wise, you will make foolish choices. So that is why it is better you get wisdom at all costs. And that is why you should not reject advice of a parent, advice of the elders, because it is dangerous. Somebody shout, hallelujah. Now, we have looked at two people. They have wisdom. And this wisdom, through this wisdom, they become promoted. They become great men. Even in foreign land. But let's look at another man. This man is called Rehoboam. This man is called Rehoboam. His story is very interesting because Rehoboam is the son of Solomon. And you know Solomon is a man full of wisdom. But along the line, Solomon lost it. He threw away wisdom and began to act foolishly. And then, this acting foolishly translated to this son, Rehoboam. He got to the king, to the king in Israel, and he would begin to do what? To act foolishly. Somebody shout hallelujah. 1 Kings 12, from 12 to 20, but we'll not read much of it, but we'll read a few verses. Let me start from 12. He says, so Jeroboam, 1 Kings 12, from 12 to 20. So Jeroboam and all the people came to Rehoboam the third day, as the king had appointed, saying, come to me again the third day. And the king answered the people roughly. You see, before this time, the Israel nation is made up of 12 tribes. And the 10 tribes are in the north. So when Rehoboam became king, they came to him. The 10 tribes came to Rehoboam, the new king. And said, when your father was the king, he dealt with us roughly. He didn't treat us well. We have come to you so that you can treat us better. Now, he listened to them. And then he called. There were some elders that walk with his father Solomon. And then he had his friends. Then he called the elders and asked them, these people, this 10 tribe came, they said, the way that they were treated during my father's reign is not good. What do you think we can do? And they advised him that he need to treat them well. Need to treat them, listen to them. They take good advice. They take word of wisdom. Then he called his mates. Those that are his mates. He said, look, discard the word of the elders. What they are saying is nonsense. Discard it. Treat them worse than the way your father treated them. Treat them very, very, very bad. And then, what did he do? He discarded the word of advice of the elders. Like many of us do today. Our mothers, our fathers, they tell us, oh, this is the way to live. This is what to do. This is the right thing to do. You say, oh, what are they saying? What are these elders saying? What are these old school people saying? I rather talk to my mate in school. I will talk to my friend. And you go and talk to your friend and say, oh, don't mind us your mom. Tell your mom. Like some of these people say, it's a bitch. Like all those parents that they used to say. I was talking to a lady I picked in the car. And we were talking. And she told me that when she was growing up, she used to tell her friend, like her friend said, that your mother is a bitch. He said, but now, I now know better that my mother is not a bitch. My mother is the best thing that ever happened to me in life. That if she didn't train her the way she was trained, that she would have lost it. That those are friends now that are saying her mother is a bitch. He said, those ones, they cannot manage a home now. They don't even have a home. They don't have a marriage. They don't have a decent job. But she went through that with pain. But it has now come to become gay for her. That those are friends then, they're not looking up to her now. Because why? She passed through the training and her mother was able to pass wisdom to her. And now it's now become to her advantage now. So it is good that we listen to the word of elders. Because it will do us good. They know better. And you see, when our parents are giving us this instruction, when they are giving us this wisdom, it is with love. Because they have made that mistake. And they don't want you to make the same mistake. So they will say it with passion. They will say it like you should start doing it now. In whatever means it will take them to say it. But you know that they are saying it out of love. Because they don't want you to make the same mistake. And they see that you are going in that same direction of making the same mistake. So they will say it with all energy. You know the way African women talk? They talk with full of energy, full of passion. And you say, oh, why is mommy so aggressive? Why is mommy so that? It's not that mommy or daddy, they're aggressive. They are talking with passion. They are talking with love. And they want to impart this wisdom into your life so that you don't make that same mistake. Praise the Lord. Amen. So verse 30, the king answered the people roughly. He answered them roughly. And forsook the old man's counsel that they gave him. He forsook the counsel, the advice of this old man. Then he decided to forsake the advice of parents. Say, no, what are they saying? After all, I'm a PhD holder now. I'm a master degree holder now. I'm a graduate now. I'm this now. I'm a living cert now. And my parents didn't go to school. They can't even put two sentences together. So why should I listen to them? If you do that, it's a big mistake. This king forsook the old man's